Once you start looking under the hood, you'll get some sense of the lay of the land with matrices and how they relate to transforms. Here's a map of the sort of things you'll find. The upper left area of the matrix is where rotations and scales show up. If a transform changes only this area of the matrix, it's called a linear transformation. I'm not going to spend time on the formal definition of this term. The additional course materials include resources for more on the underlying math. The definition is fairly basic stuff about how addition and multiplication are preserved, but doesn't have much effect on how we actually do computer graphics. The upper right is where the translations accumulate. These translation values will get affected by multiplication with other matrices, of course. Translations only affect points, since vectors have zero for their fourth coordinate. 3JS provides a function, called Decompose, to extract the translation, rotation, and scale components from a matrix. The translation and scale factors come back as vectors, as you might expect. The rotation comes back as a quaternion, something we'll talk about when we get to animation. The short version is that a quaternion is a compact way to store the axis and angle of rotation for a rotation matrix. One useful property quaternions have is that you can easily interpolate between them, which is useful for interpolating between two different orientations. Notice that the bottom row is always 0, 0, 0, 1. The transforms we covered here are called affine transforms. Parallel lines stay parallel when an affine transform is applied. In modeling, you'll essentially always use affine transforms, so we never change this last row. Since GPUs are tuned to use 4x4 matrices, most of us just use 4x4s everywhere for simplicity's sake. When we discuss perspective cameras, we'll set the values in this last row. We'll then be using a projective transform. With affine transforms, when a point's coordinates are multiplied by the matrix, the fourth coordinate starts out as 1 and ends up as 1. This last row in a projection matrix modifies that fourth coordinate to be something other than 1. What that means is something we'll leave until a later lesson.